I want to do one more example, kind of reviewing this idea of object-oriented programming and using two classes or more to interact with each other. And so I thought I'd do a little program that calculated compound interest. This is something that I believe has been called the eighth wonder of the world. Who said that? Let's see who said that. Eighth wonder of the world. Compound interest. Albert Einstein? Could it be? It's on the internet, so it must be true. Okay, a few different sites are saying it, so either he really said it or they're all copying each other. Compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. He who understands it earns it. He who doesn't pays it. Great, great words there, Albert. Okay, do you think Albert Einstein, do you think people called him Albert or did his friends call him Al? I don't know. Anyway, so we're going to create kind of a, this is a public class for I don't know, something like a bank account. Okay, this is your account. In fact, we won't even make it a bank account because it could be other type of account. But this will be our account, and this will be the main method. Public static void main string. Args makes it the main method. And automatically makes it the driver class, the one that's going to be telling the rest of the program what to do, kind of controlling that. And so I'm going to need to get some information here from the user. I'm going to need to get their, so I'm going to import the java.util.asterisk, or I could just do the scanner, I guess. Either way. And then I'm going to build a scanner. So scanner in equals new scanner system dot in. Okay, and all I want to do initially is find out how much money there is in the account. And so I'm going to create a double called balance and set it equal to 0.0 to initialize it. And this is just the account balance. Okay. Once I have that information, now how am I going to get the balance? Well, I need to ask the user for it. So I'm going to say system, so get the balance from the user. Now, wouldn't this be nice, by the way, if we could just, this is how we got our bank account set, we'd say, how much money do you have in there? I have $1 million. And they set it based on that. So this is just a silly example, obviously, but in order to be able to do this calculator, I need to know how much money they have. So system.out.println, what amount is in the account? And then we're going to store that into our balance variable. So balance equals in dot next double, so that'll read that in to the balance variable, and now I have it that I can do this compound interest. But compound interest is something I'm using for this account, but it may be something that I want to do on many different programs that I'm creating. And so I decide, or maybe I'm working on a team and I want to do this in parts. Either way, I'm going to build this out into a second class called public class. I'll call it calculators. So I can put a series of different calculations in here that do various things. And one of them is going to be public, and I'll just put void for now, compound interest. Okay. So if I want to call this compound interest, what information do I need? Well, first of all, I need the balance. And I'll just leave it at that for a second. Okay, so I need the balance of the account so I know where I'm beginning with. Because the account could apply to other things. I could make deposit, take withdrawals, do all this stuff with the balance in this account class itself. But compound interest is kind of a specialized thing. So how do we calculate compound interest? Well, we're going to need a few more pieces of information other than the balance. One is, what is the interest rate that you're earning? So I'll create a double variable called interest rate and set it equal to 0.0. We need to know the term that we're looking at, and that can be an integer called term, and that's the term of the interest. How long are we calculating? This is the rate represented as a decimal, so we can do math with it. And then we need to know how often this interest rate is compounded, but for now we'll just assume it's years. Okay, so this is the term of the interest in years. All right, so we've got these pieces of information. Once we have that, it's a fairly simple calculation, but we're going to need to create one more variable to keep track of the updated balance so that we know we get the interest coming into the balance. And so what we're going to do for this interest rate is start and go for the term. Now, we don't have the interest rate, we don't have the term. And I'm even going to separate those out a little bit and then call this one the calculated, because the first two we're going to need to ask for. And this is going to be the calculated balance. All right, so first is we need to get more info from the user. And so I'm going to ask the user, system.out.println, what is the interest rate? And then I'm going to store that in the interest rate variable. I need to build a scanner, though, to be able to store it. And this is just, I wanted to demonstrate this little principle here, is that if I can create a scanner here, import the java.util.asterisk or scanner, and then I can build the scanner in equals new scanner system in. I can do it that way, but think about what's happening. I've created a scanner here and I've created a scanner here, and both of those scanners are going to exist in memory. If I do my little dumb drawing here of memory, so this is the memory, each of these scanner objects is going to take up space in memory. And if you picture any given program, there can be, you know, maybe every class in 100 different classes uses input, and so there's all these scanners built in memory, and what are they all doing? Well, they're all just reading in from the console, so why don't we just share the scanner? And so what we're going to do is, in our compound interest method, we'll just require that they pass in a scanner along with the balance. And now I no longer need to build a scanner in my this class. It'll only be built in the other class. Now, some of you very adept students are saying, well, aren't we just building another one here? And the answer is, yeah, we would be normally. Like when we do double balance, it creates a new variable. But when we pass an object like a scanner, there's something that happens called a pass-by reference, meaning that instead of passing the object itself, I pass the location of the object in memory. And so that way we are more efficient, we better utilize our memory, because this is going to actually refer to, if it's an object, it's going to refer to the scanner that was actually built over here. This is just going to be the address. Go here and you'll find what you need. We still need to import the scanner. If we didn't have this line in here, of course, it's not going to like that statement. I need to say equals in dot next double. Okay, but it's going to say cannot find that symbol scanner. We still need to do the import, but we now can pass that scanner to be used in various classes if that's what we choose to do. So just as an example, and anything that we can create, we can pass. So we can pass arrays, we can pass obviously individual variables, and we can pass objects like we did here. Now, this should compile just fine. So I'm going to get the interest rate, and then I'm also going to get the term, and I'll store that in the term variable, so term equals n.next int. Okay. Now I have all the pieces of information that I need in this compound interest class. I just need to pass that information to this method on the other side. So how do I do that? Well, again, the name of the class is calculators, and so in my account class, in the main method, I'm going to need to build an instance of the calculators. So I'll say calculators, and why do I do it there instead of down here? I could have done it wherever. I just like to kind of group my objects up in a group and my variables in a group to keep things a little more organized when I mess up and need to try and find them later. So I'll say calculators. I can give it whatever name I want to, blah, Bob. I'll call it C since it's calculators. And I'll just say that's a new instance of the calculators object, calculators class, that I'm going to call C. Once I have this information, then I can pass to that class the information that I need. So I can say C dot, and then what's the name of the method? Well, it's called compound interest. So C dot compound interest, and I have set it up so it needs to be passed two things. One is the balance and one is a scanner. So I say, well, I've got the balance here. I'll pass that in, and it's named balance. And then I'll also pass in my scanner, which is called in. So these two things are going into my compound interest that I'm passing into them. Again, the fact that balance here is named balance here, it doesn't need to be. I could just call it B over here if I wanted to. It doesn't matter. This is what it's called in the main method. And this is what it's called in the calculator. So if you looked at it, it would be calculators.balance and main.balance. So in fact, I will do that. Over here, I'll call it principal, because in compound interest, that's how we look at it. This is the principal. Okay. And I hope that this is the correct spelling, because it's going out on YouTube. So. All right. So now that I'm calling, I've created an instance of this calculators class. I've called it C, and now down here I'm saying go out to that C object, the calculators class, call the compound interest method and pass it these two things. One is the balance, which is going to hold whatever balance the user just typed in, and the other one is the scanner that reads in from the console. I'm going to pass both of those things over here, and then the compound interest method will take it from there. Okay, and we'll continue to look at this in the next video. Spencer out.